Hello, everybody. How are you doing? That's great. Today's episode is another story time because you guys liked the last one, so I thought I'd bring back another one. So if you guys want more story time, please let me know in the comments down below. Anyway, today's story is when my girlfriend left me on Valentine's Day for my ex-best friend. Okay, so let's get started into the story. So at this time, I was kind of questioning my sexuality and dating different genders at this time. So at this moment, I was really liking this girl. It was Shay. She was my friend. We talked about her in the last episode. So I was confessing my feelings to her, and I asked her if she likes me and all this stuff. And she said yes and all this. But apparently, S and Shay were having a sleepover that night, and S was telling Shay to tell her that, oh yeah, tell her you like her and all this stuff, after I confessed my feelings to her. And so she did, and then they planned to actually break my heart. So what's the plan? So you're going to act like you like her for a few days until the Valentine's dance, and then I'll show up with a giant heart, and then you can run up and kiss me and tell her that you actually like me instead. So at this time, Shay and S were dating a lot, but not exactly at this time. I don't know, they were going through a lot of things, and I really liked Shay, and I didn't think about it, and it's all in the past now, but still, I really like Shay, and but I guess it just never worked out that way. Anyway, so they planned on actually hurting me on Valentine's Day, but I didn't know about this at the time. This was all told to me later on by C. But anyway, so I was at home all excited, being like, oh yeah, she really likes me, yay, she really likes me. And I was getting super excited, but little did I know what was actually in store for me. So it's a new day, and I'm at school, and me and C are friends at this point, and we're putting our stuff away in our lockers, and I decide to tell her. Oh, by the way, me and Shay are dating. Again. Again? Really? It didn't work out the first time. I know, but that was because of me. That was my fault. Yeah, but this happens all the time. You guys just aren't right for each other. Just let Shay have S. Trust me, they will work out better. But I really... Just listen to me. So, I guess I probably should have listened to C that whole time. C was kind of right. Sometimes I wonder if C knew beforehand what was going on, but I doubt it because she was just as surprised as I was, but you'll see. So then we were all in class because we had class together. So I remember I was trying to talk to Shay and try to be cute with her, but she was like totally uninterested, like all the way. Like, it was so embarrassing. And S was being like totally cute with her and like hugging her and holding her hand and touching her and all this stuff. And I was like, what? And she was like, yeah. I kept talking to her and like wanted to be more interested about what she was doing. And I'm like, what's going on over here? So yeah, I just talked to C and C talked to me, and we kind of discussed about how it was a little weird, because it was a little weird. I mean, like, she wanted to be my girlfriend. She told me she wanted to be my... Or when I asked her to be my girlfriend, she said yes. And that was, like, the night before this. So, like, what was going on? And I was so confused. So then lunch happened. And we always had a routine that we would go out for lunch, even if I didn't have money. Anyway, S and C always seemed to always have money. So anyway, we'd always go out to 7-Eleven. So this time, S and C were walking ahead of me and Shay, and me and Shay were walking together because I thought, why not? We're dating, quote unquote. We should walk together. So we did, and these guys ended up walking way up ahead of us. So I don't know what they were talking about, but we ended up talking the whole time. And Shay was just like not interested. She seemed like she didn't want to be there. And the whole time I kind of knew. I knew something was off. I was like, kept trying to like ask questions. Are you okay? All of this stuff. And I still, now when I look back at it, it was like so obvious. I should have realized it, but I didn't. I didn't realize. So we normally got nachos for lunch, so that's what we pretty much had. And S was being super cute with Shay, and I was obviously getting jealous, and I was still wondering, like, what the heck's going on here? Why is she not noticing me? I thought we were dating. I was super confused, but these two were just purposely trying to hurt me. Later on, I was at home texting Shay, wondering why she wasn't answering me, and it was really irritating, and oh my god, I should have noticed, and I'm just gonna keep saying that because I really should have noticed. I was just so blindsided. Anyway, I was texting C, and I was seeing if C knew anything, and C didn't really know anything, and I was also texting S at the same time too, but we were doing other things on the side. But like, I thought they were friends with me at this time, yet this happened, and then after this happened, I was still friends with them afterwards. Like, why would I stay friends with these people afterwards? But I did. I stayed friends with these people afterwards. Anyway, Shay wasn't answering, so I just went off to bed, even though the next day was Valentine's Day. And I was thinking about what I would make her and all this stuff. So, the next morning on Valentine's Day, when their plan was to unfold and I was not to notice, it happened. Me and C and Shay were putting our stuff in our lockers, and I was getting ready to talk to Shay, and then out of nowhere, S walks up the stairs with this giant Valentine's card and these chocolates, and Shay turns around and goes, "Oh, thank you!" And I was like, "What the heck?" And she's like, "Oh, by the way, I'm breaking up with you." And I was like, "Damn." And I went off to class and I didn't know what to think. I just, I don't know. I didn't see how bad these people were until later on. Like, these people shouldn't have been my friends. Anyway, I don't know what they were doing out in the hallway, but talking and chatting and whatever. Then later on, yeah, they were just talking in the hallway about who knows what. So after that happened, I was sitting at a desk by myself, and we had desks of twos. So C ended up coming up and talking to me. By the way, they planned that. Oh, I mean, I should have noticed it. I mean, all the signs were there yesterday. Yeah, I kind of noticed they were acting weird yesterday too. It's okay, I don't really want to talk to them or hang out with them anyway. And for a while, me and C actually didn't talk to S or Shay for a while. And me and C were like, that was like the closest time our friendship was like ever. And then we eventually did become friends with S and Shay again, but it took a very long time. Yeah. So the conclusion to the story is my heart was broken on Valentine's Day by my girlfriend who started dating my ex-best friend. That's one great story. Well, that's the end of this story. This all happened before I took S's boyfriend, which we talked about in the last episode. But maybe she did deserve me to take her boyfriend if this is what she did to me beforehand. If you guys did like this, please hit the thumbs up button. If you want to see videos every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell. And I'm still doing my Discord event, so if you'd like a chance to win some Amino coins, please get Discord and let me know, and I can send you the invite to the server. And yeah, I'll see you guys in a later video. Bye!